Hey, what's up guys, my name is Anwar and you're watching Hacks and Geeks. Well, this is the part 1 of building Lineage OS and there'll be 3 parts of these, and the last part is a video on fixing the common errors that you may face. And in the first part, I'll show you guys how to set up a virtual machine with Ubuntu running on it. Even if you know how to set it up, I recommend you to watch this video as I'll show you the configuration and the specs that you'll need in this video. The computer that I'll be using to build Lineage OS has an Intel Core i7-6700HQ, 16GB of RAM and an approximate 220GB of SSD disk space. Well, actually you don't need all these to build, you can even carry out this on a Pentium machine, but it's likely that it's going to run out of memory or processing power, plus it would take ages just to complete a single build. I'll be using an SSD for this build, as even a 7200 RPM hard disk is much slower than an SSD and this will affect the build time by a great extent. So let's start by downloading the Ubuntu OS from www.ubuntu.com. All the links that I'll mention in this video will be under the description and also in the blog post, which is also linked below. It's recommended that you download the latest version, so for this build of Lineage OS 14.1, I'm downloading Ubuntu 16.04.1 LTS, as that was the latest available version at the time of recording this video. Here, click on download. Now you will be taken to this page where you can donate some money for the development of the OS if you want. But mind that this is a free OS and you can download it for free by scrolling down and clicking on not now, take me to the download now option. It should start downloading the ISO file right away. If not, then you can manually click on the download option and then start downloading. In the meantime, while it's downloading, let's download VMware Player by going on to VMware's website, and at the end of the page you will find VMware Workstation, which is a paid version, and other is the VMware Player, which is a free version, and we are going to download that by clicking on the download product and then by downloading the 64-bit .exe file for Windows. Once downloaded, open the file and then begin installing it by accepting the terms and conditions, and then by clicking on next, and at last click on finish to complete the setup. Now you will have an icon on the desktop to launch VMware. Once you launch VMware, select the option that says use VMware for free non-commercial use only, and then enter the email address and then click on continue and then on finish. Once the Ubuntu has been downloaded, click on create new virtual machine and then select the option that says install a disk file, and then click on browse and navigate to your downloads folder and then select the Ubuntu ISO file that you just downloaded. Now click on next, and here you can set up the OS login information. For the sake of this video, I'm going to keep the username and full name as Lineage, and I'll keep a single digit password and then click on next. Here you can type the virtual machine name. I'm going to put Lineage OS and then click on browse. Now navigate to the folder path where you want to store the files, and I'm going to select my 220GB SSD for this and then click on OK and then click on next. Here select the option that says store the virtual disk as a single file, and then change the maximum disk size to your preferred size. I'm going to change it from 20GB to 200GB and then click on next. And here the disk space matters the most, as you'll have to download a lot of source code and allocate the space for your cache. And if you start building for multiple devices, it's likely that you'll run out of storage. So it's recommended that you at least set a minimum of 150GB of disk space. And if you notice here that the RAM memory just says 1024MB, so to change that, click on customize hardware. And I have a 16GB of RAM, so I'm going to allocate around 10GB of RAM for this virtual machine. And it's recommended that you at least allocate 8GB of RAM for this. And below in the processors tab, you can change the number of processor cores that you want. I'll select 4 cores and then check the option that says virtualize Intel VTX, and also the one that says virtualize CPU performance counters. These will help boost the virtual machine performance. And below you can go to the display option and then select the number of displays that you want if you have something like a multi-monitor setup going on. Once you change all the settings, you can click on close and you'll see that the changes will be made, and then click on finish and this will start up the virtual machine. and you'll get a pop-up to download and install the virtual machine tools. Now you have to click on download and install, and the setup will continue in the background. Once the retrieving files options appears, it will be slow and will require your internet connection, but it won't be using it properly. So click on the small arrow to get the drop down details and then click on skip, as we'll set this up later once the installation is finished. After a few minutes, once the installation is completed, you'll get the login screen. Enter your password and log in. Once the desktop appears, wait for about 5 minutes and then restart the Ubuntu virtual machine, as at the idle time it would have installed VMware tools, and once restarted you should be able to get to the full screen mode. Anyway, now I'm going to the settings option here and then select the software and updates, and in here it says download from United States server. Now click on that and then select other, and then click on select the best server. This will run tests on few of its servers and then it'll select the best server for you. Now click on choose server and then enter your password. Now click on authenticate. Once done, close all the windows. Now click on the icon on your desktop that says search your computer and then type terminal, and then open the terminal app. Once open, right click on the icon and then select lock to launcher, so that it will be easier to launch, and most of the building process of Lineage OS is done through terminal commands. Now type sudo apt get update and then hit enter and then type the password. But you won't be able to see the password that you type, but just enter the password and hit the enter key and this should start updating. All these commands will be in the blog post so that you can just copy it from there instead of typing. Once done, type sudo apt get upgrade and hit enter. And if it asks for the confirmation, type y and then again hit enter. And finally, you can go to the settings and then select the brightness and lock option, and then set the screen of time for never, and then set the lock option to off. And that's it guys, you have completely set up the virtual machine for building Lineage OS. And in the next part, I'll show you guys how to download the source code and set up the build environment and also build Lineage OS for one device. And all the links for the other parts of this video will be under the description and also in the blog post, where you can find all the terminal commands that you would need and also all the videos. Thank you for watching the video guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did enjoy, then a like rating will be awesome, and for more videos from us, hit that subscribe button below, and thank you once again for watching guys, goodbye.